So welcome to Gloucester Cathedral. My name is Luke Jerram, and I'm the artist behind the Earth artwork Gaia, which is inside now. And it's a replica of the Earth. It's 1.8 million times smaller than the real thing, 7 meters in diameter, and it's created from high-resolution NASA imagery. And the reason I made it was I was interested in the phenomena called the overview effect, which is something that astronauts report sort of when they go into space and they look at the Earth for the first time. They're often overwhelmed by the beauty and the awe and wonder of looking at the Earth floating in the blackness of space, a very beautiful, awe-inspiring experience. And when they come back to Earth, they often become environmental campaigners as a consequence of this overview effect. So I wanted to create an artwork that would sort of give the public a sense of what that might be like. And obviously, yeah, we're halfway through the sixth mass extinction of species on our planet. We've got climate change to deal with. And so I wanted to create an artwork that would act as a safe space, a place where people could have perhaps those difficult conversations that we all need to have about changing society so that we are more sustainable and dealing with the problems that we're faced with. So that's the artwork in a nutshell. It's comes with a surround sound composition by Dan Jones, a very beautiful piece of music that has the recordings of space astronauts, and you've got David Attenborough talking about climate change in there as well. And what else have we got? There's the sound of people talking in all the different languages. I like the idea that people could listen to all, if you could float above the Earth and listen to all the conversations going on at the same time. That was an idea I had in there. The artwork is this sort of installation artwork for people to experience, but it also acts as a venue for people to program events beneath it. So we've had choirs singing, we've had people doing yoga under the Earth and lectures on climate change. So there is an opportunity for other people to be creative, and that's quite important for me with a lot of the artwork I make. Okay, I think that's it for me. I hope you enjoy the artwork, and thank you very much.
Apollo 8, this is Houston. It's a good picture of the horizon. We can't see many terrain features as yet. Apollo 8, Houston, we're beginning to pick up a few craters very dimly. The whole thing is pretty bright.
Roger, there's not much definition up here either out of the horizon. We're now approaching the craters C and Bassett.
Roger.
I'll shift to the rendezvous window.
It was the fourth orbit when we finally came to a position where we saw the Earth.
Earth coming up. Wow, that's pretty. Get a color film, Jim?
And then Anders asked me for color film.
Hand me a roll of color quick.
Oh, man,
you?
That's crazy.
Quick.
Yeah, I've got it right here.
Let's get up.
No, I got it framed. It's very clear right here.
And he and Anders does take, I guess, several pictures. And I say 250 at F11.
Oh, I got it right. Oh, that's a beautiful shot.
And as Anders takes the pictures, one of them, as we learn after we get back home, became the very famous one.
When we launched, after about 25 hours of climbing up away from the Earth towards the moon, I started taking pictures. We separated from Saturn. We were able to turn around and get a view of the Earth. You could almost see it retreating. It's like a kid watching his clock in the school. You know, the hand. Then you look away and it's moved a little bit. So I took a picture of the full Earth, the first full Earth man color shot, which is my favorite picture. And it showed immediately, you know, that the Earth was very pretty, very delicate. It was nothing but blackness around it. But it sure showed that the Earth was a very beautiful, but quite fragile place. And particularly as we got further out, where the Earth is about the size of your fist and arm's length, Well, you don't have to be a real mathematician to realize that if it's one lunar distance the size of your fist at arm's length, if you're two lunar distance, it's half the size of your fist. 10 lunar distances, it's like that. And 100 lunar distances, it's a pellet you can't even see. And 100 lunar distances are nowhere.
Oh, God, look at that picture over there. So when I'm curtain coming up, wow, is that great. Hey, don't take that. That's my schedule. You got a color film, Jim? Hand me a roll of color, quick.
Oh,
will you?
Man, that's great. Where is it?
Quick.
Thank you. Это трехкратный чемпион по программированию Google Геннадий Короткевич из Гомеля. Именно благодаря ему и Беларусь занимает первое место в общем медальном зачете стран-участниц конкурса. Уже пару лет за юным гением гоняются журналисты, но он обычно отказывается от интервью. И все же главному врачу удалось. Палата Калинская разыскала его адрес на Google Maps и
Thank you. Earth is a spaceship. You can't avoid the comparison between Earth.
The injustice, all these things that, you know, you certainly feel strongly when you're on the Earth, and you know that those are still there, but that's replaced for a moment by how beautiful it is.
Looking as a finite object in front of your eyes, and your own spaceship, which is closed with limited resources, all humankind being part of the same unique crew, is a spaceship. You can't avoid the comparison between Earth, looking as a finite object in front of your eyes.
I remember thinking, I wish everybody could experience this view of their home planet so that maybe it would reprioritize what's important to them and make them less angry at their neighbors and more concerned about doing what they can so that we preserve the beautiful planet that we live on.
Thank you. Right now, we're facing a man-made disaster of global scale. Our greatest threat in thousands of years. Climate change. If we don't take action, the collapse of our civilizations and the extinction of much of the natural world is on the horizon. Together, we can make real change happen. The world's people have spoken. Their message is clear. Time is running out. They want you, the decision makers, to act now. Supporting in making tough decisions, but also willing to make sacrifices in their daily lives. The people have spoken. Leaders of the world, you must lead. The continuation of our civilizations and the natural world upon which we depend is in your hands. Along with civil society, represented here today, supporting in making tough decisions, but also willing to make sacrifices in their daily lives. Because they recognize that they too must play their part. The people have spoken. Leaders of the world, you must lead. The continuation of our civilizations and the natural world upon which we depend is in your hands.